Hello everybody, Imminent Storm here, and welcome back to Crusader Kings 2 After the End. In the last episode, we were able to wage war against up north here and grab the county of Saginaw. Alright, there. Did a little bit more kind of internal management, trying to make sure we didn't have any more problems. And it looks like that we have another adventurer threat coming. So we're going to have to deal with that. Also, we were kind of thinking about what we're going to be doing about the Kingdom of the Superior here, and particularly the Michigan region. And what I was thinking of doing is declaring a Great Holy War, since I am the head of the religion, for everything in Michigan. And I'm the only, new Rus cultist liege, except for this guy up north. They are also new Rus cultist, so they may join us. Now, these guys might join against us. Let's see, what are you? You're old Rus cultist. But I think, yeah, they've only got 4,500 troops. They've got 7,500 troops. I can put nearly 11,000 troops in the field, plus possible mercenaries. So, hopefully, we'll be able to handle it. Alright, let's go ahead and unpause it, get things moving here. We're going to want to deal with this adventurer threat first, because I don't know how big it's going to be. And I don't want that popping up when they're in the middle of another war. And hopefully we don't die. Because succession's gonna be bumpy because our heir isn't exactly the best character in the world. He's got a lot of negative opinion traits piled up here. That we're just gonna have to deal with. Machinist Gottfried approaches you and presents you to you a request to buy a small plot of land. No. So let's just get things rolling. When is this adventure threat going to pop up? 29th of November, 2793. Okay. In a few months. So I'm ordering to see that Justin could use some guidance. Nope. Important decisions. We go on a salvage expedition. Let's continue to use the study. Speaking of that, how are we looking here? Temple vassal opinion. Monthly piety gain, monthly prestige gain. Let's just hit that real quick. Let's see, head penalty is zero on tolerance and legalism. Whoa, what's all this? Oh, somebody was plotting against me and we've ended that plot. Okay, that's what that was. Let's go with humility, I guess. Young Peyton has finished education in the ways of war. It seems he has learned all the basic skills required. He got a tough soldier. This is actually a much better heir. He's shrewd. Deceitful, but no one cares. Gluttonous. Elusive Shadow. He's a very good spymaster. I'd have to kill my way through a whole bunch of my own kids to get that to happen. Kind, honest, paranoid. You know what? I'd almost rather have this guy. But I can't plot to kill my own son. I could try to imprison him. It'll lower all my subjects' opinion by 40. Let's see. Got a lot of people who could plot to kill. Plot to revoke a bunch of stuff. Douglas of Douglas Host has declared Douglas Conquest of the Strip on High Fabricator Alfred II. There you are. And is that his army right there? Nope, that's Raiders. Leslie's Host. Why was it declared a victory for me? Alright, so we're just going to wait for this guy to show up, wherever his army happens to be. Young Nicholas has finished his education, diplomacy, and those with pride has attained nothing less than a masterful level of knowledge. My son. Excellent. He's a good character. He's a very good character. As he's growing older, we're going to see the Kiefer could use some guidance in some of my experienced areas. See, but I probably would need, like, elective succession or something like that to be able to, elect my son. But that's dangerous. Craftsmen that you funded a couple years ago returned to tell you of their success. Alright, perfect. Got some gold. So where is this host? So I'm not raising my army until it appears. Alright, well, let's just roll things. There it is! Douglas's host. And it looks to be about 4,000 men. Young Justin's finished his education. He's a very good character. And probably might need to just go, like, full tyrant and, like, execute all my own people. My own children. And try to get it so that the character I want succeeds. Alright. Let's get everybody gathered together. Get ready to destroy this army. That may be actually what I want to deal with before we do any wars, because I don't want to die in the middle of a war. All my vassals are going to hate me for doing it. Alright, we're gonna get in there, we're gonna defeat that army, no problem. What is this, Raiders? Yep, send them home, alright. A new realm, Emperor Alejandro of Velez has decided to abandon his nomadic life. Okay. Probing is forging diamonds meant to fabricate a claim on Enterprise of Southhold. Go ahead and use it. We'll take it. Means a little bit of money. Where are you going? Running away, are ya? Alright, we've got some recruitment bonus. Alright, they're going to Louisville, huh? My liege, it pains me to say, but there's a traitor in the realm. This rotten egg is plotting your downfall. I enclose the damning evidence with this letter. Who is the traitor? Let's see. My marshal. He's one of the guys that actually likes me. This seems fishy. Oligarch of the Strip. I should notify the supposed plotter. Let's do that. Let's see, 14th of January, 12th of January. Yep, we got him. Finally. Victory, 77%. Chase him down. He's, how far is he running? Crusade for the Ozarks fails. 21st, 26th, we're not going to get there. We're going to get him there, though. Too late. Holy cow. Finally, wiped you out. All right, you. What's your name? Douglas? Oh. I don't have a chancellor. Okay. You then. Alright, you guys march back. Master Librarian? Nope, nobody can be Master Librarian. We need a commander. Anything else we can do here? Eunuch, dwarf? No. Pleasing me. Charismatic negotiator. What's this? The increased council power. Oh, I should have threw you in jail while I had the chance. Send these guys home. You guys. We send them a gift. Throw some money at these guys. My cousin. Okay, so we have some sons. This one or this one. I mean, his marshal's pretty low, but or even this one, who would serve as much better heirs to the kingdom and our current heir. So, finish our study of culture. This is Prince Alfred. Oh my god, and I just died. Well, so much for that. All right, so be it. Need a chancellor. Oh my god. Oh my god. Bequeathment. Your late father Alfred bequeathed a pre-calamity pocket or watch to you. Hopefully it hasn't been damaged or lost in the confusion of his passing. Oh, of course. Okay. Okay. We need to pick a ambition. What do we got here? Groom and heir. Yeah, alright. We need to go marshal. We need to build an army. And we have too many holdings. It's a really good wife. Let's see, what's the vassals look like? Bad. Really bad. We already have an advisor. Council's discontent. All right, well, we're probably going to have to hand that extra castle out. Because I can't hold it. Alright, well, create a new vassal. What's my army look like? 4,800 men. Can we increase the retinue? No. It's going to be really hard for him to have kids because he's homosexual. So his fertility's low. So let's see if we can find some concubines. And hope that we can produce a better heir. Too long, you've restricted the political influence of your vassals. Oh, yeah. Increase council power. Elected succession. Oh, I swear to God. The Title Revocation Committee. You know what? Fine. That's fine. The War Declaration Committee hasn't caused me a problem. So, no big deal. Let's see, women not in prison, not married, not a ruler, any religion, any culture, that doesn't matter, adult, yes, great house, no. Let's go with young, so there'll be maximum childbearing years. A genius, scholars of recorded asks permission to use library, personal use, yes. A genius. Hey, concubine? Yes! Alright. You know what? I'm thinking elective succession might not be a bad idea. It'll make things a little sticky. But might not be a bad idea. Elective succession. Alright, well. Anybody else has any interesting traits? I'm not sure stewardship even matters. Let's just go with you, tank concubine, and you, take concubine. I've invited people in my court to take part in a war game. Yes, this will be fun. If we can get through it, then we could probably get some additional marshal points. Assigned task for the war game, we decide that Eisenslaus will defend with me. All right. Your wisdom and mercenary are legendary. I've decided to accept your suggestion. Yes. Alright, so we got some concubines. At the beginning of the war game, the enemy quickly tries to advance up the hills in the air to get a strategical advantage. Or just a strategic advantage. Rush forward with a light skirmish force before their force reaches the hill. Let's say that. Lenin's troops continue to move slowly, advance up the hill, pressing despite the assault of our skirmishers. Eisenslaus suggests that we should attack them from the back. Charge them while they're weakened by the pressure. Advance the main army to take a higher position than their troops. Circle around the slowed down enemy and attack from behind. Let's say that. Decision to attack an opponent who holds a defensive high ground proves disastrous. Okay, so that wasn't a good idea. Here's a court that a claimant to my titles, Prince Justin, is hiring men for an attack against me. Another adventurer threat. Present you that I must insist on elective monarchy. Take up arms, should refuse, and rest assured we have enough men to enforce our just demand. Should we let elective monarchy become the law of the land? Yeah, ruler and each lower rank vassal can nominate the successor from among themselves and legitimate children and siblings of the ruler. Dukes are valid electors in both kingdoms and empires. Elective succession is very popular with the vassals. Not approve if their king personally holds too many elector titles. You know what? Just go with it. Guess I have no choice. We'll do it. Yeah, nominated succession. So, my half brother. Let's see. Nominate one of my brothers. Let's nominate Prince Stepan. I guess that I'm only have one vote and two votes are going to my other half-brother. Which actually I wouldn't mind him being in power. As long as it's someone in my dynasty, I don't mind. So that if we go through succession, that I will continue to play. I can use someone to train with, yes. Okay. What do we still have going on here? Increase council power. You know, at some point you're going to run out of stuff to demand. Invite the plot. I'd like you to back our plot to kill Victor von Westlake. Who is Victor von Westlake? Is this guy's brother? No. Unmarried heir. Well, I actually have the ability to find a wife for him. Search all women, not in prison, not married. Any, my religion. Yes. Anybody with interesting genetic traits. A quick. Wait a minute, these are men. I was like, a genius. Arrange a marriage with my brother. Yes, all right. What it seems, Leonard of Eugenia has brought his husband Leonard out of hiding. Loses a trait in hiding. We'll take the prestige. Raiders. Okay, I don't know what that was all about. Found an empire, hold a grand tournament, salvage expedition. Victory, victory, alright. Drove the raiders out. Alright, now what's the size of our army? 9,500. Almost 12,000. What's the size of your army? 2.6. We would definitely have to hire some mercenaries to win the ground war. More raiders? Let's see. Opinion. It's improved a little bit, but it's still not great. Short reign, liege is homosexual, liege is arbitrary, liege is stubborn, liege is craven. Yeah. Liege is diligent, so that knocks out the homosexual, or the arbitrary, or the stubborn, or the craven. But there's still too many negatives piled up. We gotta get this council discontent until January 3rd, 2798. Okay, so next year, they will not be discontent anymore. He's returning a favor. Alright, we need to hand out some minor titles. Master Librarian, no one could do that. Still. Okay. Alright, well, we're getting near the end of the episode, and we got another adventure thread coming in. They're going to come in July of next year. We'll have to take care of that mess. And hopefully, once we get rid of this adventure threat, then we'll be able to try to do this great holy war. See if we can beat them. If we can prevent them from amassing into a single big army, we can probably win. does not escape me that several of your commanders lack formal training in military tactics. I would like to offer my services by training Raymond, Orville, and Edgar in the use of advanced battlefield strategies. Perfect. Yes. We will do that. All right. Well, let's go ahead and end the episode here. This game continues to be rough. Oh my goodness. Well, hopefully we'll be able to get that Second Kingdom title here in short order. All right, well, hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Go ahead, like, subscribe, and comment, and I will see you next time.